Joining us now with reaction, special assistant to President Trump, Boris Epstein is with us. I was a little shocked, Boris, to be honest. I felt that the government side, there were points that were left on the table that I would have made. Were you happy with the way it was argued?
Absolutely, Sean. And you know, this is, again, is a procedural oral argument. And the key issue here is that TRO, temporary restraining order, overbroad? And of course it is. It applies to folks that are not even in this country. And it's absolutely clear that TROs cannot be that broad, and we cannot have one judge in Washington State acting as the chief executive of this country.
Okay, the case is very straightforward, and I was a little, well, not surprised because of the history of the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. They have been the most overturned court in history. But more important, this is a straightforward case. The president has the undisputed constitutional, statutory, and legal authority to do what he did here. What gives them standing in this case, this judge standing or Seattle standing, or the argument that they were trying to make that somehow irreparable damage happened here, which made no sense to me whatsoever? These are not American citizens we're talking about.
Well, Sean, what you're referencing, and you'd be a great lawyer, what you're referencing there are the merits. And we are very confident that when this case is heard on the merits, just like the case in the Massachusetts District Court, this administration and thereby the American people will prevail in keeping this country secure and American safe.
Why do you think, and is it frustrating to you, that they were asking specific questions about the percentage of worldwide Muslims impacted by this? The one judge, Richard Clifton, in the case, he says, well, by my estimate, it was 85% are not impacted by this. So the term Muslim ban, which we all knew was false and fake news, he was basically agreeing was not applicable here. And secondly, I'm listening to the arguments being laid out. I didn't think they laid a glove on the law. Which is,
well, there's a you know, a lot of leftist spin out there in terms of calling it somehow a religious test. It absolutely is not that. This president has been very clear, and the executive order is very clear that this executive order is meant to make sure Americans are secure, and those countries which have trouble providing information, those going from that country to the United States, are already on a list, and the list was put together by President Obama and his State Department, and these are countries which are known as countries of concern, which again cannot vet its own people. So we need to provide that extreme vetting, and all we're talking about here is a 90-day pause in the case of these seven countries. That's all there is. And is that now worth it for America to make sure we're
secure? I can name 43 Muslim-majority countries, Boris, that are not impacted by this ban in any way, shape, matter, or form.
That's right.
Including the most heavily populated in the world, not impacted in any way. Boris, thank you. Appreciate it.